Here we are, back.
Back.
Back at
yes.
it.
Right.
We're talking politics.
We are talking politics.
Which I absolutely, I love this. And now we got Gary Baldwin on.
Yes.
Gary is a candidate for probate judge of Chambers County.
Mm-hmm.
No stranger to the position.
No
stranger to the position at all. You're a former probate judge.
That's right.
And now we got a week to go.
That's right. I served from 2010 to 2012.
Correct.
2.5 years. Really enjoyed serving the people of Chambers County. It was an honor and a blessing.
It really is. You know, when we get to the court, you know, which is one of many responsibilities the probate judge has, but when we get to the courthouse on election night, you know, April, the probate judge is the one that just kind of makes everything in order, you know,
that's
which,
correct.
Of course, is just a fraction of the responsibilities. Let's talk about the probate judge and the responsibility the probate judge has.
Right.
Tell me about it.
Well, in Alabama, every county is a little bit different as far as what the probate office in that county handles.
Correct.
Type of business. But in Chambers County, of course, most people are aware of dealing with the tags and titles,
mm-hmm.
vehicle tags and titles and things of that nature, because that's something to do
correct.
Regularly.
Right.
You know, driver's license renewals are handled through the probate office
mm-hmm.
In
mm-hmm.
Chambers County as well. So those are things that a lot of people are aware of. But, you know, the things that a lot of people that don't deal with regularly are guardianships, name
right.
changes, mental health,
mm-hmm.
you know, those type of things, which are very important. Adoptions.
Adoptions, yeah.
Marriages. You know, all those things are extremely important, and it's important that whoever your probate judge is, make sure that those things gets handled properly
right.
in a timely manner, because everything that you do, and every, regardless of whether it's tags or adoptions or mental health commitment hearings, maybe even, you know, handling wills and estates or recordings, all those things, it's important that it's done correctly.
Yep.
It's important that it's done in a timely manner. And, you know, when people come in the courthouse and deal with the probate office, they need to be treated with respect.
True.
Doesn't matter who they are, where they mm-hmm. come from, who their mom and daddy
mm-hmm.
is, or how much money they got,
right.
what color they are, doesn't matter.
Right.
They need to be, you know, that person that's handling their transaction needs to treat them with respect and
mm-hmm.
and that they deserve. You know, most people in Chambers County have always had to work hard for what they have.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And it's
right,
important
right.
that they get treated properly.
Mm-hmm. So what made you decide that I'm going to run for this office?
Well, as I said, I served when Judge John T. Crowder decided that he was going to retire. I mm-hmm. was appointed to that position, and I served out the rest of his term, which was 2.5 years.
Right.
And felt like that we had done a real good job considering the budget situation that was going on at that time and the economy. But we had worked hard to make sure that things got handled appropriately, that we provided all the services that was necessary for the people. We didn't cut any services whatsoever.
Mm.
And so it felt like that we had worked hard, and a lot of people had encouraged us to run again. They felt like that we had done a good job and that we had proven ourselves.
Mm.
And it's, like I said, everything that goes on there is important, and it affects everybody's life. In
mm.
Chambers County, there's not a person's life that's not affected by the probate office.
Correct. And you know, when you even get into like the adoptions or the guardianship, you know, that you know, commitment to service really comes into play there, because, you know, sometimes you're catching people when, to be quite honest, it's not their best day. You
That's
know?
Right.
It's not their best day. And
mm-hmm.
so, you know, that experience that you have, how does that prepare you for that type of responsibility?
Well, you know, with adoptions, for example, it's important that when you hold those hearings, that you make sure that you ask the appropriate questions,
mm-hmm.
that you get the appropriate answers, because at the end of the day, in an adoption situation, you're looking after that child's interest.
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
You know, are they going to be better off than they are in the current situation?
Right.
To make sure that the decision that you make is going to be always looking after their best interest.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's important in adoptions. And of course, it doesn't matter. You know, I guess within the news lately, in the last 2 or 3 years, mental health has become
yes.
sort of to the forefront with
yes.
all the things that's been
mm-hmm.
taking place.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, when you're holding those hearings, it's important that you ask those questions that are important, that you make sure that person's, they're getting the proper care that they need to get
mm-hmm.
themselves where they can participate in society.
Mm-hmm.
They're not threat to themselves or others. Mm-hmm. And I think that's critical. It's important that someone has lived some life, you know, that you've mm-hmm. been around, that you've raised kids through the teenage years, because mm-hmm. that's important. Mm-hmm. You know, that you, because that's a lot of times that's when people have mental breaks. And so it's important to be able to recognize some of the things that are going on and to make sure that they get the help that they need so that they're not a problem to society and they're not going to cause harm. And it's important that, you know, I know Mike knows firsthand, you know, when you're out there in a situation as law enforcement or whether it be the hospital, you know, someone's come in and they've got some issues going on. It's important that when that call's made, it doesn't matter if it's 2 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. 3 o'clock in the morning, 2:30, weekends, whenever it is, that call's made and the probate judge has got to be able to take care of that at
take
that point
it.
Immediately. It's important for the people that are involved. It's important mm-hmm. for that person that's having the issue. It's important for their family. And it's important to the citizens that you go ahead, that you're responsive day or night whenever that job comes up. And that's the part of the probate judge in Chambers County that's the 24/7, 365. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I made that commitment before, and I'm willing to make that again, that I'm going to be available regardless of what time it is, that we're going to make sure things get handled in an appropriate, timely manner.
One question that come up out of the probate judge's office, and I know there was some debate on the Lynette Annex. Mm-hmm. Your probate judge, day one. Do we keep the annex the way it is, or in your opinion, is there any modifications that we need to be done?
The services there should be provided all the hours
right.
that's open. I know when I was probate judge, we didn't close for lunch.
Correct.
The office was open, you know, from 8 to 5,
right.
Monday through Friday, and, you know, we rotated lunches. We mm-hmm. we cross-trained our employees so that whoever was doing renewing license could do car tags
right.
and titles.
Right.
Vice versa, the people that were doing car tags and titles, they could renew driver's license for whomever came in. So I think it's important to have that office open during lunch, working people. That's the only time they have to come in and take care of their business.
Sure, mm-hmm. sure.
And it's important sure. that the services are provided.
You're right.
You know, and if you need to go in and renew your driver's license, 75% of the driver's license renewals are done at the Van Annex. I mean, at Lynette
Annex. Lynette Annex,
wow.
correct.
And,
and I think that was probably, yeah. I think when the conversation got mm. going,
right.
and I'm not here to say whether it was good, bad, whatever the case may be, I think that was the problem. And, mm-hmm. and I think that's when the debate got so heavy, because you're right, at least over 70% of license renewals were done in Lynette at the Annex.
Right.
You know, so, I mean, it is... It's, and I'm sure people would probably ask you that, you know,
sure.
on the thing. So,
that's right.
One thing I find interesting too, and your experience of working with people, of working with others, how important is that? Because basically, the probate judge is going to be working with that county commission. How
that's
important
right.
is that?
Well, it's, you know, with all departments, whether it be the county commission or mm-hmm. The sheriff's department or the other district court judges, the circuit court judges, or the revenue office, everybody in the courthouse, you know, we're there to serve the people.
Correct.
And it's important that we all get along well, we work well together, we try to support each other, because at the end of the day, as I said earlier, it's all about service.
It is.
If you're there to serve the people, you're going to do what it takes. You're going to work the extra hours, you're going to work weekends, you're going to do whatever's necessary to make sure that the job gets done, mm-hmm. and it gets done in a timely, professional manner. And
right.
I can't keep reiterating that, but that is so critical.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And, you know, it's, we always want to try to work to make things better.
Correct.
In the office. You know, one of the things that I want to try to do is to make sure that we have more online access to more of the records that are available
mm-hmm.
to make
mm-hmm.
it easier. You know, a lot
right.
of people are out here doing family
that,
trees.
Yes.
They're trying to do, you know, all types of things to do research
mm-hmm.
Concerning their families and all. So it's important to try to have more of those records online to help preserve them, because a lot of those records are from back in the 1800s.
Right.
Those books are getting old, and every time they're handled, and it damages
mm-hmm.
It is a
record.
It's a,
so it's critical that we get the rest of the records. A lot of those
right.
are
mm-hmm.
online, but a lot of them are not. So
it,
my
mm-hmm.
goal is to try to get all of the records online so that they can be preserved.
Mm. And boy, which that probate judge's office is such a historical place too. Mm-hmm. I love going down there to Lafayette for that.
Mm-hmm.
What was that, April?
With 12 days to go, what do you want people to know about Kerry Baldwin if they have not made their decision?
Well, I think one thing that most people will tell you about me, I've been involved in public service for over 30 years. It's critical that we're there to try to help people. We're there to serve people. And I think that if you ask anyone that will tell you, the 2.5 years that I served as your probate judge, we took care of business.
All right.
I'm not saying that, you know, in a negative way by any means, but it's the fact that we tried to get things handled in an appropriate manner. We took the job serious.
Mm-hmm.
We were willing to do whatever it took to serve the people, to make sure that all the people that we dealt with, like I said, whether it be mental health commitments or adoptions or just, there again, just handling a transaction for a tag renewal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It doesn't matter what it is. It's extremely important. It's important that people get treated with respect. You know, people don't understand a lot of times that people that come in that office, maybe they've had a loved one that's handled that for a lot of years, and for whatever reason, from sickness or death or whatever may have occurred, they may not be used to coming and doing that type of transaction.
That's right.
And so you need to make them feel comfortable when they come in. You know, nobody wakes up in the morning and says, oh boy, I get to go to the probate office today and give them my money.
I know I don't.
But when you do, you want whoever's there to be helpful.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You want them not to make you feel like that you should have known this or you should have known that. Mm-hmm. It's whatever transaction or business they're trying to do.
That's right.
I've heard that before.
That's a good point.
Well, you should have known.
But that's not the way they need to be treated.
That's true.
They need to be, you know,
that's
if you can legally help somebody do
that's
what
true.
They want to do, then you need to do that. You
that's
need to
true.
Go the extra mile to help them handle their business and make them feel comfortable. When they walk away from that office,
right.
they need to feel like, you know, those people,
they really helped me out.
I appreciate what they did.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And that's important. I mean, that's what it's all about.
No doubt at all. I recently got
my license renewed in Lafayette. I was actually there to handle some more business. I had to pull out my license, and they were expired. Oh, Lord. They said, April, you need to go around there because you're going to be on the news in a minute with this expired license.
Right.
But they were so helpful and so nice. But I understand what you're saying. You got to ensure that with all of the employees.
Correct.
That's true.
And that's so important. And,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, customer service is what it's about.
It is.
It's
mm-hmm. Serving the people.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And that, at the end of the day, that shows through. It really
mm-hmm.
will. If you're there for the right reasons and you enjoy your job,
right.
and you enjoy what you're doing,
there you go.
Mm-hmm. It's pleasant for everybody.
That's right.
That's what it's all about.
Kerry, mm-hmm. of all the elections, and June 5th is a busy day.
That's correct.
And you know, because I have been, you know, I go back 6 months on this when we qualified, when we started, everything like this. Of all the races,
right.
in Chambers County, I would say, no shadow of doubt, this probate judge is the most important election on the ballot for June the 5th. I mean, it is that important to Chambers County. It is so important. Why is it so important?
Well, because it affects everybody's life.
Right.
In one way or another. All the different areas. And that's the thing. In the probate office, it's so diversified.
Mm-hmm.
The many different jobs and the many different entities that you deal with.
Correct.
And the people. And there again, you know, and you're dealing with people at a different time in their lives, you know, and especially with state situations,
right.
you know, they've just lost a loved one.
Correct.
You know, I think that's the misconception a lot of times. Of course, as probate judge, you don't have to be an attorney. And one of the reasons is because even if you are an attorney, you can't give legal advice as a probate judge.
Correct. I'm glad you said that. That is so important. I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah, but the one thing that is important is that a lot of people that have not handled that type of situation, because most people don't, maybe once in their life,
right.
or maybe twice, if any.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's important when they come in, they just want to understand the process.
Mm-hmm.
They're nervous. They're, you know, they've lost a loved one, and so
mm-hmm.
They just want to know what takes place. So you can explain the process and make them feel more comfortable about what's going to take place and how it's involved.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I think, as we said earlier, it's critical that you're there for the right reason. I think you need to have someone that has experience, because that job is so diverse.
It is.
It takes a while to learn all the different facets that's involved in the probate office. And like I said, I've been there 2.5 years. I think I've proven my salt, as the old saying goes.
You know, mm-hmm.
I can get it done. Mm-hmm. I'm willing to do it if the people are willing to let me.
Right.
I think that they'll find that they will be pleasantly surprised at what they'll get.
Well,
they'll get somebody that's going to work hard for them day or night, weekends, doesn't matter.
You hit the nail on the head. That's why this race is so important, mm-hmm. and that's why it's so intriguing. And with, 12 days left,
right.
it's a big decision,
that's
obviously.
Right.
And like I was telling Mike, I have, for me, being able to stand back and take a look at everything, you and Paul especially, y'all have run such a great race, and right. it has been so informative. And we got 12 days.
Yeah.
We got 12 days to make up our mind on one of the biggest positions, biggest responsibilities in Chambers County, that being the probate judge.
Yeah, it's very important.
Definitely.
I think experience
mm-hmm.
is
I do.
It is.
Yep, I do.
Very
I think it's very
so.
Important. Yep. All right. This is Kerry Baldwin. He's running for probate judge of Chambers County.
Kerry Baldwin.
In the Republican primary on June the 5th.